دوستان سلام مجدد به تعقیب قسمت اول فیلم وار ماشین که خدمت شما به نشر رسید این قسمت دوم نقش حامد کرزای رئیس جمهوری از بقا افغانستان در این فیلم به شما تهیه و آماده ساختیم در قسمت قبلی دیدین که کرزای در اولین دیدارش با استنلی مکریستال قمندان عمومی نیروهای نظامی آمریکا در افغانستان در وضعیت ملاقات کرد که مصروف عیار کردن DVD بلوری برای تلویزیون دفترش بود و تصویر کرزای را طوری در این فیلم آورده بودند که یک رئیس جمهور بیخبر از اوضاع کشورش یک رئیس جمهور بیغمباش و شخص همیشه مریض و بیکار است اینجا در این قسمت دوم فیلم هنگامی که این جنرال آمریکایی میخواهد که در ولایت هلمند از وجود تروریستا پاک بسازد و عملیات وسیع نظامی را در این ولایت به انجام برساند بایستی از حامد کرزای حکم این عملیات را طبق قوانین افغانستان بگیره و وقتی به دفتر حامد کرزای از طریق تلفن تماس میگیره کارمند دفتر کرزای میگه که جنابشان در دفتر کاریشان نیست و در خانه تشریف دارند بعدش همین جنرال میگه که به خاطر جدیت موضوع تماس مرا به تلفن شخصی کرزای وصل بساز کارمند دفتر کرزای میگه که جناب رئیس جمهور تلفن شخصی ندارن مکریستال میگه که این چی گونه رهبر است که یک پای تلفن نداره من خودم به دیدارش میایم و برایم همین لحظه وقت ملاقات بگیر ما بقیه را در این قسمت ویدیو ببینین بسیار جالب است
Thanks, Bernie. Let's assume this is happening. I'll give you the green light as soon as I get it.
Yeah, I have a man on the line.
Hello, who am I speaking with? This is General McMahon. I need to speak to President Karzai urgently. I understand he's not feeling well, but I need to speak with him. Is he awake? Good. Put him on. Put the call through. What do you mean he doesn't have one? What world leader doesn't have a phone in his bedroom? Does he have a cell phone in there? To try cell phone.
Straight to voicemail.
What? Well, tell him to turn it back on. Please. Please. This is... I can't... oh, fuck it. I'm coming over there. This is me doing that right now. I'm making the appointment right now. Yes!
Ah, General, please come in.
Mr. President.
Please sit here. Please, sit. Sit. How are you?
I'm fine, sir. I've been trying to contact you.
Ah, yes, I'm sorry. I'm not feeling well.
I understand, sir. But did they not tell you this is urgent?
Oh, you know how everything is at the top of the mountain, General. Everybody's urgent about everything, all the time. Everything is important. Nothing ever really is. There's nothing that cannot wait until morning.
This is important, sir. We hope to launch Operation Mushtarak tonight. And I need your official consent before doing so.
Really?
Yes, sir.
Why?
Because it's your mission.
It is?
Yes, sir.
No one has ever asked me to approve a mission before.
Well, that needs to change. This mission needs your consent. If we're to win the trust of Helmand Province, it demands that this mission be seen to be of your design. I don't mean to be rude, Mr. President, but it is imperative that you begin to take a leadership role here. We cannot win this thing alone. Without your active involvement, our presence here will never be anything more than a foreign occupation. This is your war, for your country, your people. Again, I'm sorry, sir. But you need to behave like a leader.
But I am behaving like a leader. I'm unavailable. I am as unavailable to you as is your own president. You have my approval, General. You both know it was never really mine to give. But I thank you for inviting me to participate in the theater of it all. And good luck. I wish you much success.